ChargerLab had done multiple charging tests on the MOVESPEED 140W BD3.1 charger. This time, we got its yellow version. And we are going to take it apart to see its internal components. Remove the plastic film. The box is silver with MOVESPEED printed on the front. And the specs info are printed on the back. Open the box. It contains a charger, a dual USB-C cable, and some documents. The braided cable has the same color as the charger. The connector has a double layer design. And the braided design allows for a longer lifespan. The length of it is about 120 cm. ChargerLab powered ZKM003C shows it can support 50V, 5A, and has an eMicro chip. It can also support USB 2.0 and PD3.1, 240W. The charger comes in a bright yellow. The MOVESPEED and 140W are printed on the front. The specs info are also printed on the input panel. Model is YSFCG107-140Y. It can support input of 100 to 240W, 50 or 60Hz, 2.0A. The highest charging power of USB-C 1 to USB-A is 140W, 100W, 20W, 20 and 2.5W respectively. And the total charging power can reach 140W. Here are the foldable prongs. There are 4 output ports. The output panel shows the maximum output power of each port. And 4 ports are all orange. The size of it is about 74x74x31mm. It is smaller than the Apple 140W charger. And the weight is about 298 grams. ChargerLab powered ZKM003C shows the USB-C 1 can support PD3.1 and DCP charging protocols. And it has 6 fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, and 20V, 28V, 5A. The USB-C 2 can support FCP, ICP, AFC, QC3.0, SFCP, PD3.0, QC4+, DCP, Apple 2.4A, and BPS charging protocols. And it has 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The protocols supported by USB-C 3 are the same as those supported by USB-C 2. And it has 3 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 2.22A, and 12V, 1.67A. The USB-A can support FCP, ICP, AFC, QC3.0, SFCP, DCP, Samsung 2A, and Apple 2.4A protocols. Now, let's start to take it apart. Use a spudger and a hammer to remove the cover along the gap. The PCB module and the prongs are connected by wires. And the wires are soldered to the PCB module. Cut off the wires. The PCB module is filled with punching compound. The foldable prongs are fixed with screws. Take out the PCB module from the case. The PCB module is wrapped and insulated by mylar sheets. And there are copper sheets on the outside of the mylar sheet for shielding. The copper sheets are connected to the PCB module through wires. Remove the mylar sheets and copper sheets. And clean up the PCB module. There are fuse, common mode choke, capacitors, and transformer on the front. The PFC controller, PFC rectifier, and flyback controller are on the back. ChargerLab fully adopts PFC circuit and flyback topology with synchronous rectification and fixed voltage output. Next, we'll take a look at each component starting from the input end. The input fuse marked with 932 is from Betterfuse, 5A, 250V. The resistor marked with 1.5-11 is used to suppress the surge current. The blue resistor from SGLG is used for overvoltage protection. The common mode choke is wound with magnet and insulated wires. The safety actual capacitor is from DGCX, 0.33 microfarad. This common mode choke is also wound with magnet and insulated wires. The other safety actual capacitor is also from DGCX, 0.22 microfarad. The bridge rectifiers are soldered on a small PCB. These two bridge rectifiers are from Pingwei. They are connected in parallel to reduce temperature with 8 amp 1000 volts. The fume capacitor is from JURCC, 0.68 microfarad. The filter inductor is wound with magnetic ring and insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. Here is another filter inductor, 0.47 microfarad. The PFC controller is from Onsemi. It is based on a VSFF method. The VSFF maximizes the efficiency at both nominal and light levels. The PFC MOSFET is from WAYON and adopts T0220F package, 550 volts. The sampling resistor is used to detect the current of the MOSFET, 82 milliohm. The PFC boost inductor is insulated by tape. The PFC rectifier is from JJM and adopts TO-277B package, 600 volts, 10 amp. The filter capacitor is from JSH, 420 volts, 100 microfarad. The master control chip is from Onsemi. It is a high-frequency resonant PWM controller with flatback topology. It supports a wide range of power supply, overheating protection, and other protection functions. The filter capacitor that powers the master control chip is from Yuguang, 10 microfarad, 100 volts. These two MOSFETs are from Navitas and they are connected in parallel, 300 milliohm. The transformer is insulated by tape. The SMD well capacitor is from TRX. This blue well capacitor is from DGCX. The optocoupler from Everlight is used for PFC control. Another optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The digital multi-mode synchronous rectifier controller is from HYA silicon carbide. It can support multiple working modes such as DCM, CCM, PFM, and QR. It can also support power supply voltage range of 3 to 25 volts. These two synchronous rectifiers are from Liho Macro and adopts DFN 5x6 package, 120 volts, 7 milliohm. These two solid capacitors for output filtering are from GSH, 1000 microfarad, 35 volts. This is another solid capacitor for output filtering, 220 microfarad, 35 volts. There are filter capacitors and buck inductors on the front of these buck PCBs. The USB-C sockets, buck protocol chips, and MOSFETs are soldered on the back of the PCBs. There are protocol chip, buck inductor, and filter capacitor on the PCB of USB-C 1. The buck has the synchronous buck controller, synchronous buck MOSFET, V-bus MOSFET, and USB-C socket. The synchronous buck controller is from Deep Pool. It can support an input voltage of 35 volts and loss compensation. These two synchronous buck MOSFETs are from CR Micro and adopts DFN 5x6 package, 60 volts, 2.8 milliohm for each. The buck inductor is insulated by heat shrinkable tubing. The solid capacitor for output filtering is from JSH, 220 microfarad, 35 volts. The protocol chip is from Onbright and adopts QFN 16 package. It can support PD 3.1, output of 28 volts, and an output of 140 watts. The VBUS MOSFET is from CR Micro and adopts QFN 5x6 package, 40 volts, 4.5 milliohm. The resistor is used to detect the output current, 5 milliohm. Here is the orange USB-C socket. The buck inductor and filter capacitor are on the PCB of USB-C 2. The other side has the buck protocol chip, synchronous buck MOSFETs, and USB-C socket. The buck protocol chip is from S-Modware. It supports multiple protocols and dual-port independent current limiting. It can also be used in fast charging of any USB-C and USB-A ports. This synchronous buck MOSFET is from Liho Macro and adopts DFN 3x3 package, 40 volts, 4.2 milliohm. Another synchronous buck MOSFET is also from Liho Macro and adopts DFN 3x3 package, 40 volts, 5.5 milliohm. Here are two MLCC capacitors. Here is the solid capacitor for output filtering, 220 microfarad, 35 volts. The resistor is used to detect the output current, 5 milliohm. The buck inductor and filter capacitor are on the PCB of USB-C 3. The other side contains the buck protocol chip, synchronous buck MOSFETs, and USB-C socket. The buck protocol chip is also from S-Modware, the same as that of the USB-C 2. This synchronous buck MOSFET is from Liho Macro. Another synchronous buck MOSFET is also from Liho Macro. Here is the solid capacitor for output filtering, 220 microfarad, 35 volts. The VBUS MOSFET is from Liho Macro and adopts DFN 3x3 package, 30 volts, 8 milliohm. These two resistors are used to detect the current of USB-C and USB-A, 5 milliohm for each. This is a PCB of USB-A. The back has a TVS. The orange USB-A socket adopts widened pins for high current. The MCU is from ChipC. It integrates 12-bit ADC and 8-bit flash. It also has S2C and UART ports. Well, those are all components of the MOVESPEED 140W PD3.1 4-in-1 charger. It is equipped with 4 ports and comes with a dual USB-C cable. After taking it apart, we found it adopts 3 independent buck circuits to achieve 4 ports fast charging and automatic power distribution. The PCB module is wrapped and insulated with metal sheets and copper sheets, and it is filled with poly compound. The internal structure is compact, which effectively saves space. All of this makes the charger smaller than the Apple 140W charger with even more ports. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!